Dr. S. G. V. Subramaniam is currently working as professor in the Environmental Studies Department of Anna University, Chennai. He has done 8 master's degrees including MBA, 6 postgraduate diplomas, a degree in law and doctor of philosophy in the field of environmental management and environmental law. He has done his postdoctoral work in France under the Indo-French Cultural Exchange Fellowship and at Germany under the DAAD Fellowship. He has been awarded UN Fellowship and done diploma in international lawmaking and diplomacy from the University of Joensuu, Finland. He is involved in several environmental impact assessment related consultancy works. He has guided several students for their master's degree program project works. To his credit, nearly 77 papers have been published and presented in various national and international conferences. He has been nominated by His Excellency Governor of Tamil Nadu as Senate member for 2 terms to the Tamil Nadu Dr. Ambedkar Law University. He has been nominated as expert member for the State Environmental Appraisal Committee for 2 terms by the Government of India. He has served as member board of studies in the Legal Studies Department of University of Madras. Right now, he has been nominated as member board of studies in the field of environmental studies in the Thiruvalluvar University. He has written several chapters in the leading books in the field of environmental law.
Welcome to the UGC lecture series. Today, we are going to see on the implications of climate change for India. The contents which we are going to see now, number 1, climate change, why and how, number 2, what is greenhouse effect, number 3, what is global warming. What is a climate change, why and how? Climate change is due to global warming. Global warming is due to greenhouse effect. Greenhouse effect is due to rise in the greenhouse gases, and increase in greenhouse gases is mainly due to combustion of fossil fuels. Then the next one. Thus, climate change is a human induced one. It is an accelerated greenhouse effect. Climate change is generally equated with global warming, and global warming is attributed to greenhouse effect. Now, prior to that, let us know the difference between the weather and climate. Because in every colloquially we say today weather is fine, or sometimes people will say today climate is fine. So, where we have to use the word weather, where we have to use the word climate, or what is the difference between the weather and climate? First, weather refers to physical state of atmosphere at a given time in terms of temperature, rainfall, relative humidity, and sunshine, and so on and so forth. Then what is the climate? Refers to average state of weather required at least for 30 years of data to find out the climatic normals. Then the second difference decides the crop production and thereby crop productivity in the case of weather. In the case of climate, decides the geographical distribution of crops and farming systems. For example, tropical crops, then we are saying subtropical crops, we are saying temperate crops, all these things based upon the climatic conditions or the geographical distribution is based on the climatic variations. Now, the third difference, due to day-to-day farm operations are dependent on the weather. Farm planning is dependent on the climate. Then the next one, crop, pest, and disease incidence is dependent on the weather. Hotspot areas of pest and disease incidence and the geographical distributions can be delineated based on the climate. Then the next difference, extreme conditions of weather like floods and droughts and cold and heat waves depending upon the weather condition only. Extreme weather prone areas can be delineated based on the climatic conditions. Then, what is the difference between the climate variability and climate change? Climate variability, it is a local and regional phenomena, whereas a climate change is a global phenomena. Then the second difference, year to year or season to season, changes in rainfall and temperature in the case of climatic variability. In the case of climate change, long-term changes in rainfall and temperature over a period of at least 30 years. Then the next difference. Examples, 2002, 2009 and 2012 were the drought years in India. 2010, wettest and warmest year. 2012, hottest year in the Afghanistan. 2012, some regions experience floods while droughts in some regions within India. In the case of climate change, the examples, temperature increases globally by 0.74 degree centigrade during the last century and global temperature minus 15 degree centigrade. It is likely to increase 2 to 3 degree centigrade during 2100 AD. Global temperature is likely to be 17 to 18 degree centigrade. Then one more difference, short period of weather changes resulting to heavy crop loss. It may be due to occurrence of floods or droughts and both and cold and heat waves. In the case of the climate variability, long period changes in climate lead to decline in agricultural production or change in cropping systems. Difference between the climate variability and climate change. In the case of climate variability, the rainfall shows a cyclic trend. In the case of climate change, the temperature shows a linear trends. You can able to find out the difference. One will be in the cyclic form, another is in the form of a linear with reference to the time. Then the next one, we will see about the various disasters. Natural disaster. Then, what are the natural disasters? The first one, earthquake, tsunami, which was hit in the south and east west coast of India. I hope you will be remembering the date, 26th December of the 2004, and wreck havoc of the volcanoes. Then, the next natural disasters, namely the global warming, global cooling, ozone depletion, UV radiation. Of course, they are taking place at the slow rate. It is not a sudden and sharp one. Then we will see about the floods, droughts, cyclones, anticyclone, thunderstorms, dust storms, ice storms, snowstorms, lightning, cloudburst, mudslips, landslips, forest fire outbreaks, heat and cold waves, and sea level rise. Now, this has got the interrelationship also. For example, because of this one, first one, loss of wetlands. Wetlands play an enormous amount of the role in preserving and protecting a separate ecosystem. Then second one, deforestation and degradation of the natural forest. Third one, indiscriminate sand mining, groundwater depletion. Then what are all the various factors which affects that, which leads to the global warming and the greenhouse effect? Carbon dioxide, water vapor, methane and nitrous oxide. Aerosols, black carbon. This leads to global cooling. The previous one leads to the global warming. And what are the various factors which affects the ozone depletion? Then chlorofluorocarbons, sulfonate particulates and other air pollutants. They are causing the ozone depletion in the atmosphere. Let us go to the climate change. What are the basic issues in the climate change? First one, Earth climate varies naturally because of a variety of cosmological and geological process. Climate change refers to an additional and relatively rapid change induced by human action. Here, it is an additional and relatively rapid change induced by the human action. So here, it does not mean that nature itself not doing so. Whatever the human process, it accelerates the same process. Then the additional change, several degrees of centigrade within a century, will disrupt the foundations of the life on Earth. The next one, ecosystems and life generally have evolved within a narrow band of climatic and environmental conditions. This is nothing but the ecosystems and life are highly sensitive to the climate change. even a rise or fall of few degrees centigrades, it will affect tremendously the ecosystem. In that ecosystem, for example, in the case of animals, it will be affecting seriously the reproductive system. The next one, what is a greenhouse effect? Our atmosphere is nothing but a thin layer of gases around a huge bulky planet. This I will be showing diagrammatically in the next few slides. This gaseous outer ring and its greenhouse effect makes life on Earth possible by regulating the Earth climate. Then, without a greenhouse effect, days will be much hotter and nights will be much cooler, and the life on Earth may not be possible without a greenhouse effect. Greenhouse effect is really good, but human accelerated greenhouse effect is bad. The process of heating up of the globe by greenhouse gases is called global warming. Now you can see the definition of what is a global warming. Now, global warming is considered to be the fever of the earth. Suppose our body temperature is 98.4 degree centigrade. If there is any rise of 1 degree centigrade or 2 degree, if it comes to 100 degree, we will say that you are suffering, we are suffering with the fever. Like that, when the earth temperature rises even 1 degree or a few degrees, it is considered to be the fever on the earth. So, when human being getting the fever, you have to give the treatment. Like that, you have to give the treatment for the global warming also, that is the treatment for the earth from the fever. Now, I am diagrammatically representing what is a greenhouse effect. The first one, solar energy. Of course, it need not say, the sun rays passes through the earth atmosphere, much of this energy is absorbed by the surface of the atmosphere. Now, the sun is here, now the solar energy is falling over the earth. This is what diagrammatically represented. Now, whether all this energy are absorbed by the earth? No. Some energy is being reflected back into the system. Some of the radiation is reflected back towards the space. We can see it diagrammatically. Now, the third one, trapped warm. Reflected energy has no longer wavelengths that cause molecules of the greenhouse gases in the troposphere. Now, this atmosphere is divided into troposphere, stratosphere, and ionosphere. The troposphere is considered to be the lowest range layer of the atmosphere to move more rapidly. The rapid movement of these molecules traps heat in the troposphere, warming of the planet. This is called the greenhouse effect. I hope you would have understood what is the greenhouse effect. Now, what are the various gases that causes the greenhouse effect? This is the next question. First one, the gases that are affecting this way are called the greenhouse gases. Other words, the gases which is leading to the greenhouse effect, they are considered to be the greenhouse gases. What are those greenhouse gases? First one, carbon dioxide. Second one, water vapor. Even though water vapor is not a gas, but this is also causing the greenhouse effect. Third one, methane, namely the CH4. The fourth one, nitrous oxide, or we can say oxides of the nitrogen, but major one is the nitrous oxide. Then global warming, the higher levels of the carbon dioxide, methane and other greenhouse gases accumulating in the atmosphere enhances the natural greenhouse effect, raising the global temperature. Now, when these gases are accumulated here, automatically it prevents the heat to go out, and the trapped heat is re-radiate back towards the earth, and this will lead to the, what is that, global warming, or this greenhouse effect leads to the global warming. I hope you would have understood what is a greenhouse effect and the global warming from this picture. Then, for the greenhouse effect, you see this visible energy from the sun passes through the glass and heats the ground. This is a glass house, and inside the glass house, this is the visible energy from the sun passes through the glass and heats the ground. Now, infrared heat energy from the ground is partly reflected by the glass, and sometime it is trapped inside the glass. And whatever the heat energy trapped inside, this leads to the warming up of the inner air temperature. This is what exactly happening at the global level. A phenomenon of the greenhouse in which glass roof allows the solar radiation to pass through but prevents the escape of the heat or infrared radiation, that is the terrestrial radiation generated inside the greenhouse. As a result, the inside temperature will rise and allow tropical plants to grow or temperate soils without any discomfort. Now, let us move to the next slide. Greenhouse effect. This was named as greenhouse effect by J. Fourier, a French scientist, in the year 1827. This temperature inside the greenhouse can be higher by over 10 to 15 degrees centigrade. Glass is a good conductor of light, but a bad conductor of the heat. Greenhouses, huge greenhouses, not to be confused with the green buildings, spread over several acres, are built in the temperate regions for growing plants during winter season. Just to show the example, what is that greenhouse effect? Just giving this example, a closed car parked under the sun, it gets heated. You see, the sun's energy passes through the car's windshield. Energy re-radiated from the car interior cannot pass back through the windshield. With the result, the inner atmosphere or inner, that inside cabin of the car, gets warms up. This is what exactly happening in the greenhouse effect or in the global warming. And here the shield is supposed to be the greenhouse gases, namely the carbon dioxide, methane, nitrous oxide and water vapor. A mother left two kids in her car in United States of America, a locked car, and parked it under the sun and went for shopping. When she returned, both the kids died in their seats. The mother was arrested and prosecuted. Why? Why? That question you have to answer at the end. Now, next one. How to demonstrate the greenhouse effect? Take a set of four glass jars of the same type and size. Put a thermometer in each. Keep two jars under the direct sunlight, one with a lid and another one without a lid. Then third one, keep two jars in shade, one with a lid and another one without a lid. After a few hours, note the temperature in jars under the sun and shade with lids and without lids. What is the difference do you find? Account for them. I will put the question at the end. You have to answer for that. Now we will move on to the global warming. This is the sun. Now the energy falls on the earth. Most of the sun energy penetrates the atmosphere and strikes the earth. Some is reflected back to the space. Atmosphere containing the heat trapped gases, while some of the sun's energy is re-radiated back into the space, much remains trapped within the atmosphere and further warms the earth. This is what the global warming. Now let us see the annual greenhouse gas emissions by various sector. This is the industrial process. It amounts to nearly 16.8%. Power stations, 21.3%. Waste disposal and treatment. During the waste treatment, a lot of methane gas is being emitted and carbon dioxide is also emitted. That amounts to 3.4%. Land use and biomass burning, 10%. Residential and commercial and other sources, 10.3%. Then fossil fuel retrieval, processing and distribution, 11.3%. Agricultural byproducts, 12.5%. Transportation fuels, 14%. This is what a broad general breakup of the annual greenhouse gas emissions by various sectors. Greenhouse gases, we can call commonly heat trapping gases. CO2, I have shown the molecular structure. CH4, methane, I have shown the molecular structure. H2O, water, again I have shown the molecular structure of this one. What is the CFC? CFC is nothing but the chlorofluorocarbons. N2O, nitrous oxide. O3, ozone. SF6, sulfur fluoride, etc. So, these are the major greenhouse gases. Now, sources and contributions of the various greenhouse gases. First one, carbon dioxide. The percentage of warming it causes, nearly 55%. What are the various sources of the carbon dioxide? Mainly the burning of the fossil fuels, deforestation, biomass burning and automobiles. Then the next one, methane. What is that percentage of warming? 15%. Then, what are the major sources? Cattle digestive tracts, paddy fields, termite mounds. Then, CFCs, chlorofluorocarbons, in that 11 and 12, that percentage of warming? 55%. What are the major sources for these chlorofluorocarbons? Fridges, ACs, and coolers. Then, N2O. N2O is nothing but nitrous oxide. What is the percentage of warming? 6%. What are the major sources? Nitrification process. Nitrification process occurs on the earth because of the bacterial action. And O3 and H2O. O3 is nothing but ozone. H2O is water. The percentage of warming? 7%. Then what are the major sources? Automobile emissions and water vapor. One cow can produce 73 liters of methane per year. See this? This is the methane, not the milk. Then CO2 level in the atmosphere. I have just put it on that, what is it, in the form of a block diagram. This is what? 280 ppm, 1900, 385 ppm at present, and 2100 it will lead to. This is what that model predicts, 550 ppm. Carbon dioxide versus temperature rise. How the carbon dioxide plays a role in the rising of the temperature? Economics of the climate change. It could cost the global economy almost $7 trillion by 2050, equal to a 20% fall in growth if action is taken on the greenhouse gas emissions. Taking action now could just 1%, $350 billion of the global GDP, that is the gross domestic product. Source: Stern Report, IPCC, Department of Environment, 2006. This is what it is shown here also. Carbon dioxide, ppm, and the rise in temperature, 400, 450, 550. If this increases, means it is nearly 4.5 degrees increase in temperature, 4.5 degree centigrade. Changes in temperature, degree of Celsius from 1990 to 2100, rise in around of 3 degrees thought most likely. This was thought in the model, it was predicted in the model, but in practice also this is almost the same. 2000 2020 2040 2060 2080 2100, it will lead to 3 degrees increase in temperature. Then predicted to rise by 2 to 4.5 degrees by 2100, even if carbon dioxide levels are stabilized at 550 parts per million, roughly double the current levels. You see that increase of temperature, 3 degrees. You may be thinking it is only a 3 degree, but the effect of the 3 degrees will be enormous, that we will be discussing in the course of our lecture. Changes in the sea level, centimeters, 1990-2100. Projections of rise in 2100 range from 28 centimeters to 43 centimeters. Even if carbon dioxide concentrations are stabilized, sea levels could rise by further 38 to 80 cm by 2300. You see that 2000, 2020, 40, 60, 80, 2100. You see that increasing in the sea level from 2000 to 2100. So, enormous amount, or it is going in the steep way upward. Recent additions to the greenhouse gases. PFC. What is the PFC? Perfluorocarbons. This where it is used, substitute of CFC, chlorofluorocarbons, and also byproduct of aluminium smelting and uranium enrichment process. This PFC is being emitted in this process. Then SF6, sulfur hexafluoride, used in insulating the material in circuit breakers, also used in detecting water leaks. Then third one, sulfur dioxide on the other hand has got a cooling effect. So, in summary, let us see what are all the points we have discussed in the last 13 minutes. 1. What is a greenhouse effect? 2nd one, what is global warming? 3rd, what are the various gases which causes the global warming? We have seen all these things. Now, let me ask the following questions. First one, what is a greenhouse effect? Second question, what is a global warming? Then the third question, when I was showing in the 10th slide, I was just telling you that the three tumblers, one kept on the direct sunlight, one set kept under the direct sunlight, one kept in the shade, and one closed and one open. Now, you have to answer which tumbler water is getting heated maximum. And if you say this X glass, Y gas, you have to ascertain the reason why it has got more heat. Then the fourth question, write the major sources of carbon dioxide, methane and chlorofluorocarbons. This one also I have discussed, you recollect it and tell me the major sources of these three gases. Thank you very much.